Yo, DK here with another tutorial for you guys. So I think last time we had purple, like we didn't put purple as any, like, purple doesn't have any enemies, so the insane AI behavior is not gonna really kick in for purple, so we're gonna just fix that up right now. So I'm gonna show you guys this. Hold on a second. Screen capture my triggers box. You guys should know how to get to this by now. And just, you know, click this, and we get this box. Get that box. Just clear for, because that's purple. Go to conditions always. That we want to do that, and then we're gonna just copy this, and have purple be enemies against orange and red, which are player 5 and player 1 respectively, like so. Okay, and instead of ally, I want to change them to enemy, like this. Just you guys should be able to do this right now. Just, I'm not gonna bother showing the screen capture that box because I already showed it in my previous videos and whatnot, and voila. And now this will make purple attack, you know, red or orange, like if he feels like it. Doesn't matter, he's got purple's gonna choose randomly and whatnot, man. And then as for orange and red, well, we already had orange set player one as enemy, but we're gonna just add that to, we're gonna add player four as enemy too, so orange can retaliate against the Protoss purple. Same goes with the red turn, so I'm gonna set purple as enemy, and voila, like this. And now all the computers are like not friends with each other. Voila. In this tutorial, for example, we as player 7 are allies with player 4, as you can see over here. And same goes with purple. Like, see, purple's friends with us, ally with player 7. So basically, and then by doing this, I showed earlier, purple is gonna immediately attack using its first attack pattern, which is 12 zealots. And I also added 2 supply depots for red, so it can start making more SCVs, because I noticed that I didn't kill these units, so it didn't like make the custom AI for the turn to be more functional. So that's what I did, and yeah, and you'll see purple expanding to here and whatnot, and it's pretty straightforward. And as for this tutorial, I want to go over some triggering and whatnot. So let's go to this box again. Okay, shows now. So I guess the most important thing is, like, in a standard campaign map, you wanna have, like, instead of pre-placing like this map revealer right here, like what we did in the last video, we're gonna remove that. And we're gonna put, like, okay, so we already have this location box already, so we're gonna just, instead of pre-placing the map revealers, the 3 map revealers, I wanna just say that once we get to this location, it's gonna show a map revealer here. So how can we do that? Well, first of all, go to scenario, go to triggers, like this. Go to, and then on the new box, click new. And you should have this box. And, you know, just pick the player 7, that's us, the trigger. Click next. And then go to, like, and then in this box, which I have to screen capture again, we're gonna go with bring this time. So if you scroll down, there's bring here, and then we're gonna say, like, we're gonna say, like, player 7, not player 6, player 7, like player 7, like, see right here. Or it can be current player, it doesn't matter. Current player means player 7 in this case. So it either way works. Brings, let's say, brings exactly one. Go to Terran UED here. I'm not gonna add the window box because you guys should know this. You guys can just find it where to get this. Once you click that, just select the units that you wanna have the trigger function, and to the location we're here. Okay, so boom, there we go. What does that do? So what we're gonna say that once once we do that, we go to the action trigger box, and then it starts off like this, and we're gonna scroll all the way down to create units. We're gonna say that the quantity, we're just gonna put one. And as for unit, okay, maybe I should screen capture this box. We're gonna say like under I think it was neutral units. Under neutral units, yeah, go to special, and you see the map revealer here. Click that. Okay, create one map revealer at one location. This location. This location, as in the Protoss Insane AI. For the current player, or in this case, player 7, that's us. Boom, finish. So what does this mean? So let me move this box real quick. So you guys see that location box there? This location box. So what we have here is that player 7 brings exactly one UED hero to we're here. So we're here as in this space over here. And then it's gonna make a map revealer all the way to this over here. Alright. So yeah. And then let's say for simplicity's sake, we're gonna make the purple AI function once we get to them. So instead of always, we're gonna like change that up. So open this box again. And instead of always, delete that. And let's just do the same thing, bring like player 7 brings exactly one, like, you know, UED hero, the Goliath guy, to we're here. And boom. So what does this mean? So that means once we bring our UED hero to like over here, that base over there, it's gonna make purple like function, and it's gonna do that by having the computer set to ally with us. It's gonna set the orange and red as enemies, then it's gonna start running the script, and it's gonna set the purple to have 2,000, you know, minerals and whatnot. Yep. And that's only for purple. And as for us, once we get there, we're gonna have a map revealer placed upon them. So yeah, that's what we're gonna do. And then if you're wondering, let's go to the forces, and instead of instead of white building, that's our building, right? Let's change this to a neutral player. So let's say like blue. Let's change this to like blue. Okay. Then we need to obviously put a starting location for blue. And then we're gonna say that, so since this belongs to a neutral player, like even if we get close to it, we won't be able to control it. So how can we, and it's not a rescuable command center, as in it's not teal. So how can we have blue give buildings to us? So that's pretty easy. So go to triggers. We have this. I'll move that over here. And then, you know, go to, so it can be, we can do it two ways here. We can have, so I'm gonna do the first way, though, my way, I guess. We're gonna go to player 7, which is not showing the box for some reason. Hold on a second. Let me remove some boxes real quick. Okay. Yeah. Alright, so, hold on. I'm gonna re-add the box. So go to triggers, have this box, click new, screen capture this, then the first way is by doing going to player 7, that's our trigger. Next. And then say that it's the same thing again, like bring. Oh, okay, not this. This. What? Alright, I can't seem to move this box for some reason. Okay, that's annoying. Okay. Conditions. Okay, not this. Triggers. New condition. Alright. Oh, I can move. So bring, same thing, player 7. Or current player, doesn't matter. Player 7, okay, I'll just use current player. Because it works the same way. Anyways, current player, that's us. Brings exactly one UED hero, or it can actually be at least one. That's same thing. Not same thing, but it works in this case. Brings at least one UED hero to we're here. Then we click next, and then I'm gonna add this box again. Screen capture this box, and no wonder it's coming. I forgot to add music. Okay. Okay, let's add some music. So we get this box again, and then scroll all the way down to give units to player. So it shows all this quantity units owned by a player at location, blah blah blah. So what we're gonna do is it's gonna show this box once you click that. It's gonna show this box once you click it. It can be all units, as in if there's like, if you put like other buildings over here, like let's say a supply depot, then it's gonna give all the buildings if you set it like all buildings like this. But we're not gonna do that, we're gonna be specific here. So give one and then click buildings, and it's gonna show that same box as this, the unit box like this. And we can choose a specific unit. So once we click that, it's gonna show this box. And we're gonna click turn building, turn command center. Okay. And then we got that. Give one turn command center owned by who? Owned by whom? Owned by player 2. Because that's the neutral, the blue color. Player 2 is blue color. Player 2, owned by player 2 at where? It can be anywhere. It can be anywhere like. It can be anywhere, as in anywhere in the map, or some specific location that we set, as in like we're here. In this case, it works. This we're here works, or anywhere works. But yeah, we're gonna be more specific. When you're making a map, you want to be specific. So we're here, unless you want to be general. But at this location, to who? To us, which is the current player. That's us. Or it can be player 7. It doesn't matter. Like it's the same thing. So what does this, so let's review back here. Once we bring current player, as in that's us, player 7, brings at least one UED hero, the teal Goliath, to we're here, that is gonna have blue player 2 give one tank commander to us, player 7. Okay? It's pretty simple. So basically that. So that's one way. Or we can do it this way. Go to new again, which is not showing the box for some reason again. But let me remove some stuff real quick, guys. Remove some box again. Let's see. Add screen capture. So that's the first way was that. Another way is this. We can actually have player 2 this time have a trigger box, and then let's say. Go to new, and then we get this. Go to the brick box, and just have player 7 bring like at least one or exactly one. Doesn't matter, exactly one or at least one, up to you guys. Like UET to what we're here, like that. Then we're gonna go to the same box. we're gonna go to the same type, action type, which is give units to player. And we're gonna have like one Terran command center owned by player 2. Owned by player 2, or in this case it can be current player this time, because that's player 2, because we're giving player 2 the trigger this time, that's why. So yeah. Anyway, hold on a second, guys. Changing music. So it can be current player or player 2, doesn't matter. At what location? At we're here. At to player what? Us, that's player sound, to the human player. And done, that's it. So let's review again. So notice the difference here this time. So we can either do it this way, have player 2 with have player 2 have the trigger, or have us have the trigger. This and this are basically the same thing, but it depends on the perspective, that's why. So yeah. So that's up to you guys, but I think in this case, I guess I'm gonna just have player 2 do it. So I'm gonna delete this box. So it's basically the same thing. Even if I deleted it, we're still gonna have this blue command center once we bring the UED hero here. And yeah, that's basically it for that. And what else do I want to show? I don't want to get to Switch yet and Hyper Triggers, because that's kind of a bit hard, I guess. We can do like, I don't know, let's say once you get here, we want to like, instead of manually making SCV, we want the trigger to create SCV. So we're going to do this. Change the thing to location error. Make another location like this. Can name it SCB pops out, whatever. Do that like that. Put it there. So what are we gonna do with this? So we're gonna say that once we bring our UD here, it's gonna give us comment. It's gonna give this blue building to us. So this blue build is gonna turn into white. And then once we have an access to the command center, it's gonna give us free SCVs, like 4. Then in order to do that, it's pretty easy. Go to player 7. Okay, it's not showing the box as I expected. Or maybe it is. Nope, it's not. I gotta re-add the window box again, unfortunately. So screen capture that. Click new, and then our screen capture. Once we click new, we get this box. Same thing. Player 7, next. And then there's like several ways to do this. We can either go to bring and then use the same trigger formula. Go to bring or something. But this time we're gonna be specific and say command. So what does command mean? That means like a unit that you possess. So in this case, we're gonna say player 7, us, commands exactly 1, or it can be at least 1 Terran command center. So it's kind of similar to bring, but this command doesn't have a location. So yeah, so this is basically the same as this, guys. Hold on. So, you see these two of here? These two are basically the same thing. But the command doesn't have a location box that we need to set, so. It's, yeah. So anyway, so we're gonna use a command trigger this time. So once we command the command center, get this box, and then remember the create function. Create units, that's what we did for the purple map viewer. Go do that. We're gonna make like 4 Karen SCV at SCV pops out for player 7. Yeah. And voila, that's it, guys. So what does this mean? What does this trigger this for? Okay, hold on. Okay. So once we get an access to this command center, it's gonna have the command center give us SCVs in this location. Pretty straightforward. And then let's say let's make it even more interesting by saying let's have this blue building. Click on the blue building and it's gonna have this box, this property box, unit property box. So we can either click it, we can have this building as invincible or in transit. So if we click in transit, it's gonna have this building lift off like this, pre-placed. But we don't wanna do that, so let's not do that. We're gonna make it invincible. What does that mean? Okay, so it landed back down. That means that once we start the game, this building is gonna be undestroyable. It can't be targeted down. It's just to be like a, it's to ensure that the human player won't accidentally destroy this blue building or whatnot before he before the player brings the UD hero to this location. So now this building is invincible. And then how do you make this like? How do you disable the invincibility via trigger? Go to the trigger box again, and then let's recycle the same trigger, this one. So click this, and I gotta remove the box again because it's not showing for some reason. So add this, and yep. So it's gonna show it. So. Player 7 commands at least one, blah blah blah. Then go to new. And then over here go to set invincibility. Set invincible. And there's four things that we need to do. So over here, if you click set, it's gonna show this box. It's gonna show this box. So since the invincibility is already enabled, we're gonna disable it. And what Tama does is it's gonna like turn on and off and on and off and like that. So one, if you use the preserve trigger with this too, but I'll explain that later maybe. But for now, if you wanna turn off the invincibility, then we just do disable it. And then conversely, if we wanna make the building invincible, then we're gonna click enable. But in this case, we're doing the opposite of that, so we're gonna do disable. We're gonna disable our command center. So, disable, like so, for what? For Terran command center, obviously, owned by who? Us, player 7. At where? At we're here. And voila! Done. And you can also like put like some kind of a wait time for like let's say like this. So what does this mean? So once we get control of a Terran command center, it's gonna disable the invincibility of the building, and then it's gonna after 1 second it's gonna create four Terran SCVs at the SCV pops out box. Yeah, in this location right there. And of course you can also add like some kind of a like a sound file, you know, like you guys just like find your own corresponding sound and just input it, and then like, you know, like some kind of a loading sound or whatever, just to make the game more aesthetic or something. But yeah, so yeah, basically that's that. And yeah, so and then if you're wondering, oh DK, I think I got it already. What about how do I change map type? Go, you see this? Click that. Then it's gonna show this box. And right now the default setting is this balance. They're 120 by 120. And you can just like you can unclick this to like set the height and the width like manually and whatnot. So like let's say like 64 or 256 height as in like this vertical, width as in horizontal, and then let's say I don't know, like installation, and if you click OK it's gonna show this box. So yeah, so that's how you change box. But you know, and you know, you can keep doing that, let's say like 192, 256 at what space platform, like it's gonna show this. Or you can over here default terrain, can change it to space like that, it's gonna be like a big black of emptiness of space. You can go to like twilight map like this, you gonna change to water. You know, that's how you do it, man. It's pretty simple to change. So yeah, anyway, oh, and then before I start the StarCraft to show you guys what I did for today, let's add another trigger, like say I don't know, like let's once we get control of our SCVs. Okay, so hold on. Okay, let's see, remove. Add this box. Okay, so once you get a control of our SCV, let's say we get like 200 minerals and 100 gas. Okay, go to new, like that, click player 7 next, and go like, do a command, use a command condition. So player 7 commands at least 4 SCVs, like that. Then it's gonna give us, and then go to here, then yeah, then go to set resources, remember this, I did this last video, and then set player 7 or current player, doesn't matter, current player, set to 200 or minerals, and do the same thing, and but this time do gas like so. And I'm gonna change the player 7 just to show you guys this is the same thing once we start the StarCraft. And let's say I don't know, let's say like new mission objective or something, destroy the Zerg swarm and Terran dominion, blah blah blah, like that. And of course we're also gonna set the mission objectives, and it's gonna show this box. We're gonna just put the same thing, or go like this, tutorial, like that. Oh, and then UED hero must survive and whatever, like that. So actually this should be additional mission objective, I guess. Did I spell additional correctly? Additional, yeah, like that, voila. I don't know what else is there to want to do. Oh, and then we can, instead of creating units, we can also do something like, let's say like there's a player 1 Terran Dominion supply depot here. Actually let's place this like right here, I guess, player 1. No, actually let's place orange, actually. Like, let's say there's a creep colony there. So in order to have this creep colony killed using trigger, go to scenario, this time we're gonna set it to player 5, Bro, remember this, player 7 brings at least 1 UED and blah blah blah, give 1 unit. Copy this, and then instead of player 2, uncheck that and click player 5. The conditions, and then I'm gonna have to change some music. Hold on a second, guys. Let's see, which music? Okay, there we go, this one. Yes. Okay. Gonna remove that for a second, ads playing. So instead of player 7, let's say, brings at least 1 UED hero to rear here. And that's same. And instead of give 1 turn, delete that. And then go to new. Yeah, right here. Which, I'm gonna just re-add a new box. And then instead of give units or create units, whatever, we're gonna go to kill unit. But instead of kill unit, go to kill units at location. Cause what kill unit basically does is it's gonna kill everything in the map. So we don't want to do that because there's a regular creep colony in the Zerg base. So we want to just have this specific creep colony near the Terran command center to be destroyed. So we're gonna go to kill units at location, and it's gonna have this similar requirement. So for quantity, we can say like one or all, whatever, it doesn't matter. Kill all what buildings, doesn't matter. It can be buildings or you can be specific by choosing creep colony for what player? Player 5, obviously orange. At where? At root here. And that's it, guys. Done. So what does this do? So once player 7, that's us, brings the teal Goliath to this location here, it's gonna automatically kill this creep colony. And yeah, that's basically it. So let's get started with this map. Let's test it out. So yeah, I'm starting off StarCraft. So what did I go over today? Well, first of all, I changed player 4 to have alliance. I changed the alliance setting. So player 4 is gonna be aggressive against red and orange. Or red is gonna do the same against purple. Orange is gonna do the same against purple. And we have a blue building this time that's gonna turn into our color once we bring our hero there. And basically once we bring our hero there, once we get a command center, we're gonna disable the invincibility set on the pre-placed blue building command center. And then after 1 second, it's gonna create 4 SCVs near that box here. SCV pops out. And once we get control of 4 SCVs, it's gonna give us 200 minerals and 100 gas. And it's gonna show this mission objective and blah 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 blah. And finally, it's gonna automatically kill the creep colony once we bring our hero to this area. And we're gonna see if that works. Oh, and then I also forgot to go over this. And then once we bring our hero here, we're here, it's gonna make a map revealer to purple space down here. So yep. And once that happens, it's gonna have purple start running its AI behavior. So anyway, let's go over this then, if it works or not. Okay, so let's see. Tutorial time 2. Okay, let's go. Okay. Calling online. So yeah, see, this time we don't have any vision of purple. Confirmed. Okay. We lost an SCV. Okay. And then it says get to the abandoned command center, but I don't think it's gonna change. Yeah, this is different. Oh, this is I was testing this, but yeah, okay, it's gonna change later. I was testing the color for my impending Doom campaign that I'm working on, but yeah. I was using this map as a test, but anyway, you see this blue building invincible. But now, once we bring it, what happens? Yep, orange is destroyed. We get 4 SCVs, we get this audition mission objective, we get this, and now we get vision of this, and now purple starting the AI behavior. Yep, pretty simple, guys, and we get, you know, minerals and gas like I expected. And now it should change to see like this tutorial, destroy the swarm and terror dominion, hero will survive, blah blah blah, and yeah. That's basically it, guys. Let's see. Yep, red's building SCVs, getting ready to function back. Orange is doing the same, running the campaign script. And yeah, purple should be attacking. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, low. Now it's starting to attack. See? I don't know why purple's leaving two zealots not back there, but. Yeah, purple should be attacking. So if we restart this game long enough, it might attack red or it might attack orange, whoever. But yeah, I'm just here to show you guys that the insane AI behavior. If you pre-place units that have the corresponding attack pattern, they're gonna just rush at the enemy right away, which is what purple is doing right now. If I didn't place these zealots, then purple would like you know, have to start from scratch, you know what I mean? So right now it's figuring out its attack pattern, I guess, right now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. I don't know why this zealots is staying here, but yeah, even I don't know how the AI script works sometimes, but yeah, purple should be attacking anytime. So yeah, and yeah, red's building and whatnot. And orange is also attacking. So this is the thing, orange can either attack purple, me, or red, but orange chose to attack purple, I guess. Yeah, yep, like that, and here comes purple trying to defend. And if you turn off black sheep, well, it's still gonna show this location because we set a map revealer here like this. See? So yeah, so that's what I'm trying to show you guys. And eventually purple will expand to here, red's gonna expand to there, but orange is never gonna expand. So yeah, that's basically what I'm showing. And you could see it right now, orange, since I made the trigger like have orange be enemy as purple, orange starts automatically attacking purple, and purple will do the same too, man. We'll just see this attack pattern and then we'll see how orange can defend and whatnot. Yep, like that. I should have set some sunken colonies here, but yeah. And yeah, purple was keep building, see? Very aggressively building. Yeah. Like so. Yeah, that's basically it, guys. And next time I'm gonna show you guys how to load bunkers manually and some other triggers, whatnot. But yeah. But anyway, by watching this video, I guess you guys can now know how to do certain stuff for your own campaign and whatnot. Very basic stuff. But this was DK, guys. And oh, and then before that, let's does the blue player show up in the force description? Nope, blue is neutral, so it won't show. We'll see. Yeah, see, no blue. Although we placed blue, but since blue is neutral, it's not gonna show up in any of the force slots. But yeah, so by hopefully watching this video, you guys can know how to do some stuff that I showed you guys here in the future. So anyway, this was DK signing off. Bye now.